So you want to be a professional driver? It's a non-stop battle. A battle with your fear, a battle with the course, and a battle with the other drivers. The power and speed playing you in the seat. It's the best feeling on earth. I'm Vaughn Gittin Jr., Formula D champion. There's this race coming up, and I want you to enter.
It's not easy, bro.
I've borrowed this GTR for you. It's got some serious parts on it.
Now we got a race car.
Before you race, you gotta get some practice. Let's rock.
All right, you're gonna get 2 laps to hit some target times. I'll be watching, and when you're finished, I'll have some settings for you. Okay, it's best to enter corners slow, then accelerate hard out. So bad for a beginner. Okay, we're gonna lock in your settings for the race.
Sick! This is a nice turnout. We got some Porsches, some Corvettes, a couple of GTRs, some real track day weapons out there. So finish strong and you'll earn enough to buy your own car.
All right, this is it, man. Go get them. Give the other car some respect. Nice work. You look awesome.
There are plenty of cars in your budget. You've got some nice options. Choice, man. This is where it all begins. From here, you have the chance to do all kinds of racing. If you want to reach the top, first you have to make a name for yourself at the grassroots level. Try out different disciplines, like time attack or drifting. And soon you'll be ready for the GT3 or the Works Race Series. If you succeed there, you'll be ready for a seat in the GT1 World Championship. See these cool posters? They all hold events. And the numbers on each show the driver level you'll need to enter. You're starting at level 1 with entry-level modern D cars. By the time you hit level 16, you'll be a full-on GT1 World Championship driver. I think you've got some real talent. Let's see how far you can take it. All right, it's time to pick a race and get out there. Okay, let's get you back on the track. You're a part of Modern D. We're starting out basic, but that doesn't mean starting out slow. Time to prove those skills, my man. One more thing before you get started. We have to talk experience. Everything you do earns XP. Win more XP, and you'll get new cars and unlock more events. You'll take home extra cash and earn more options for vinyl, paint schemes, and rims. During a race, you'll earn more if you nail a perfect start from the grid, overtake another driver, or stick to the racing line. Then, after a race, you'll also earn XP bonuses. Bonuses are based on how you finished and how much you dominated the other drivers. They're also based on the objectives you've earned and whether you mastered the track. You can earn XP online too, when you battle your friends in versus modes or through Autolog. Basically, to earn XP, you want to fight hard, drive fast, and win as much as you can.
This is the tightest Shanghai circuit. Traffic will be busy. Hit that bridge too fast, and you'll ruin the next corner. Good luck.
Green light.
drive.
Awesome driving. You just set your first record in Autolog. Autolog's where you can meet up with your friends in the Need for Speed community. You'll have your own personalized driver profile. You'll be able to see the stats on your victories, rewards, and favorites. And you'll be sent an alert at any time a new record is set. Your friends can recommend events, and Autolog will suggest others in the recommend section. You can share photos and replays in the gallery. You may be alone behind the wheel, but Autolog opens up a world of community and rivalry.
This will be intense. Monza compacted into two straights and some heavy-duty turns. Keep your laps consistent and try not to blink. That's the green! Come on, nail this one!
Customization is all about perfecting your car. You can transform your car from a stock showroom model all the way into a fire-breathing track monster. Upgrades are all about finding that perfect balance. You can choose to upgrade your suspension, tires, brakes. You can even swap out your engine. Visual customization lets you design your own look and share your personal style. If you really want to compete with the big boys, you'll want the full works conversion. Install enough upgrades and soon you'll be able to convert your production model into a straight-up race car. Once you start customizing, the possibilities are endless. See what works best for you and have fun.
Okay, this is your first night race. It doesn't get any tougher than this.
Thank you.
showed them out there. That's P1, we're the winners. Okay, this is a shortened track with some tight bends. Last turn of the lap is a long uphill right. Take it flat out and we'll win back some time. Go, go, come on, that's the green light! Wow, you really showed them out there. That's P1, we're the winners. Okay, not many corners here, so make them count. Get the right line through the chicane and you'll fly. Just don't carry too much speed to that next corner. Good luck, man. Go, go, come on, that's the green light! really showed them out there. That's P1. We're the winners.
Someone has decided to lend you some sweet cars. We're talking Aston Martins and Porsches. Beat the lap target times and build up your XP.
Okay, two corners to perfect. Turn one, paddock hill is a downhill plunge and great for overtaking. Then Druids, a slow hairpin with an uphill approach. Good luck. Okay, watch out for turn three, crater curves. It's a right to left downhill sweep and a real roller coaster. Brake on the bend and you'll be looking at a spin. job, man. You pulled off a podium. Down Nürburgring. Some early slow corners are gone, so you'll get less shots at passing. No mistakes on that chicane, all right? Don't give anything away. driving. You nailed a podium spot.
Someone up there seen your talent. You've got the chance to battle for Modern C. Prove yourself in a full-on race around Suzuka West, and you'll be going places in no time.
Go, go, come on, that's job, man. You pulled off a podium.
You're killing it. You're up in the modern sea. There's some awesome machines coming your way. From now on, you'll get a little more bang for your buck.
Yeah.
job, my man. Great job. Up a good rhythm at this circuit, but there's a bunch of blind corners. Good luck. Go, go, come on, that's the green light. Epic drive, man. That's how you get the job done.
Driver everyone's been talking about. I hear you've got what it takes to be a good drifter. Drifting is the art of controlled chaos. You're going to throw your car into a slide and try to maintain it.
Everyone starts on basic courses.
But you step your game up, and I'll take you to the mecca of drifting, Ebisu in Japan. Prove yourself, and you'll get an invitation to Southern California's House of Drift, Irwindale Speedway.
There's going to be a serious battle for the championship. Win it, and I'll give you my Monster Energy Falcon Tire Ford Mustang. Are you ready to rock? When drifting first hit the States, it was way underground. We broke the locks at the Nevada Freight Depot just so you can go practice drifting. This is just how I taught myself to drift, sliding around an open parking lot and just having some fun. And check this out. Drift Alliance was cool enough to lend you a sick S13 to thrash. Start by driving in a wide, counterclockwise circle around the pole. Turn in hard and increase the throttle. The goal here is to find the perfect amount of counter steer and throttle to maintain the drift. Too much throttle and you will spin. Too little and you will straighten up. This is all about being smooth. Hop in that S13 and let's go drifting.
All right, here we go. We're gonna start by driving in a circle. I want you to get some good speed going before you toss the car into drift. Don't give up. This definitely takes some practice. Relax, man. You got this. Remember, be smooth with the throttle and steering. It's important to get a feeling for the right amount of throttle. Nice work, man. Looks like you really know what you're doing. Okay, I've got more practice lined up for you.
Nice work. You're killing it out there. Now we're going to learn about linking drifts and changing direction. The best way to do this is practice some figure eights. As you approach the other side of the figure eight, quickly lift off the throttle and turn the wheel in the opposite direction. If you get in a bind and need to initiate drift or change direction in a hurry, you can turn in and yank the e-brake. It will lock up your back wheels and throw you into a drift. Careful, don't hold the e-brake too long or you will just spin out. All right, I want to see you link that figure eight.
All right, you ready? Let's see what you got. Practice yanking that e-brake. Don't hold just spin out. Don't forget to lift off the throttle when you're transitioning. You're looking real good out there, man, for a beginner. Well, looks like you're really starting to get a hang of drifting. Get ready for my next and last lesson.
Alright, Vaughn Gittin Jr.'s School of Drift final lesson is all about monjing. Monjing is essentially a slalom drift down a straight line. You'll be using weight transfer to initiate your drift here. Once you have some speed, initiate drift by tossing the car in one direction and quickly countersteering the direction you want to drift. If you get in a bind, don't be scared to use the e-brake to help the car rotate quickly. Start slow and increase speed as you start to feel comfortable. Don't go too big too fast. For now, we'll keep it simple. Once you figure this out, I'll give you the whole yard to tear up however you want. After you've mastered all this, you will be on the drift circuit chasing that dream of becoming a pro. Bring your A game and don't expect me to go easy on you.
All right, let's make this happen. Toss that thing. Okay, this is when you put it all together and lick the course. I want to see some more confidence out there, my man. This sure isn't a competition, but that's not bad at all, my man. Wow, that was pretty impressive. Now you've got this whole yard to yourself, so get out there and trash some tires.
Alright, good luck out there. And don't expect me to go so easy on you next time.
Yeah.
Stepping on my home turf. Time to teach you the best way to drive sideways. Then later, we can go out and trash some tires head to head, bro.
I'm Darren McNamara, driver of the Team Need for Speed DMAC 86. We're going to be driving cars from the 80s and 90s, those classic rides tuners worked on for years, like my own A86 Corolla. When we built it, we tried to make the wildest hatchie out there. The thing's got a rotary engine transplant, and it's stripped down to 1,700 pounds. It puts out more than 500 horsepower. We've got races lined up at the Nordschleife, one of the toughest, most dangerous circuits anywhere. As well as at Suzuka, where a heap of Grand Prix champions have been crowned. So if you can win at places like that, you'll be in great shape for a world championship of your own. And you know what? I'll even put my DMAC 86 on the line. Win the championship, and it's yours.
Retro brings back the beast of the 80s and 90s, tuned like crazy with a decade or two of development. These are iconic cars going faster than anyone thought possible.
Okay, remember the highway section ends in a heavy brake for a chicane. Good luck out there. Excellent stuff. That was a great win. Track's narrow, so you live or die on your corners. Keep your speed up, and we'll see you on the podium.
Thank you.
Great driving. You nailed a podium spot. Tight hairpins. Evasu West is tough. Hammer the straights, keep your corner exits clean and consistent. Good luck. Get it next time.
You're being loaned some insanely designed vehicles. A Lamborghini Reventon, a Sterling Moss Mercedes, and an awesome open-wheel Caterham. Enjoy the ride and beat those times.
Okay, listen. The trick here is to nail the two hairpins in the middle. Stay out of the bears, everywhere else, and it's all yours. Good luck.
Thank you.
down the last two corners. A tricky 90-degree right that leads onto the suit curve. When you power back onto the straight, use the curve on your final exit. Nice driving, man. You're on the podium. Don't let the straights fool you. These corners are technical. There's gonna be tight turns, high-speed chicanes, and heavy traffic. Good luck. pulled off a podium.
Okay, man, you've got access to the Eliminator. Every time the clock runs down, the guy tailing at the back gets taken out. The last car rolling will be the one that gets the glory.
Okay, man, keep focused on the lights. Come on! Wow, you really showed them out there. That's P1, we're the winners.